There truly is volcanic chaos ongoing on Iceland's most populated peninsula, as now a 15-kilometer or 9.3-mile-long body of magma contains sections which are less than 500 meters or 1,640 feet below the surface. Lava could, with little or no warning, now appear in the ocean off the coast of Grindavik, producing an explosive eruption far northeast of Grindavik, or the most worrying possibility, within Grindavik. Because this is such an abnormal situation when compared to the last 9 intrusions of magma which have occurred on the peninsula, I have created this Q&A-style video to answer questions from my audience, as well as to analyze from my perspective as a geologist where an eruption is most likely. Where exactly might the eruption occur? Technically speaking, anywhere along the 15-kilometer long dike which is present. This could mean a singular point, a several hundred meter to several kilometer long fissure, or multiple separate smaller fissures could simultaneously erupt, and we do not yet know which will be the case or where on the fissure it will erupt if an eruption ends up occurring. However, 3 locations appear more likely than the remaining spots on the underlying dike. The most likely location is where magma first appeared in this dike intrusion near a crater row known as Sindahuka-Kigar-Ur. The second location is about 2.5 kilometers southwest of Grindavik, where magma was seemingly intruding at depth on November 11th. The third location is 650 meters northeast of Grindavik, where earthquakes during the last 6 hours have primarily been centered around. Should an eruption occur, how long in your opinion would the fissure system be? In my opinion, I would expect between a 600-meter and 2,000-meter-long fissure to form, although this would likely shrink over time to only one vent as the eruption progresses. Do I think it's highly likely to erupt soon, perhaps in the next 24 to 72 hours? Yes, in my opinion, I expect an eruption to occur by the end of November 16, 2023. If it erupts, what does this mean for aviation in the region? It depends. If any part of the eruption occurs underwater, then the eruption will be partially explosive and produce ash. This could create moderate regional disruptions of air traffic at the 2 main airports closest to Reykjavik, but would be unlikely to ground flights countrywide. And an eruption would not create the widespread Europe-wide air traffic disruptions that we witnessed due to Iceland volcanic eruptions in 2010 and 2011, as those were both 2 orders of magnitude more powerful than the strongest possible eruption, which could reasonably occur in the next week. Yet, if an eruption occurs completely on land, it might either cause no disruptions if it is purely effusive, or minor disruptions if it is Strombolian. Can this eruption be so big that a caldera forms? No, not only is the volume of magma involved in the current unrest too small and too spread out to hypothetically create a caldera, but there is not really a central magma chamber large enough to hypothetically drain to such an extent that it causes overlying rock to collapse and form a caldera. Since magma is stretching under Grindavik now, is it possible that the eruption may occur in the sea, and if so, would it be more explosive? To this I say yes and yes. Is there a chance something similar to the 1783 Lackey eruption with a very long fissure occurs, and if yes, should it be considered as an ongoing flood basalt eruption? No and no, as the volume of magma involved is once again too small, by at least an order of magnitude when compared to Lackey, and even Lackey's impressive output of 14 cubic kilometers was too small by a factor of 22 to be potentially considered a flood basalt-like eruption. Are the ongoing earthquakes going to affect other rift systems / volcanoes in Iceland? While these quakes could theoretically open an easier path for magma to intrude at adjacent volcanoes such as Eldey and Fagradalsfjall, this is highly unlikely and it is too far away to affect any more distant volcanoes such as Katla and Askja. Any increased seismicity there would be unrelated. What is the worst case scenario? That would be if a fissure not only erupts in the middle of central Grindavik, but also produces explosive activity at shallow depths in the ocean. Is it possible we might still be underestimating the effects of the explosion of this volcano? Not really, and the current exclusion zones and closures seem suitable. Since it seems like the magma is coming from the same source as the Fagradalsfjall eruptions, do you think it's still making sense to consider the Reykjanes volcano as a separate system? Despite what some news outlets might claim, the magma involved in the current intrusion does not relate to or originate from the Fagradalsfjall volcano or its magma chamber, and its current movement confines it to the area known to represent the Reykjanes volcano. Is La Palma-type eruption expected? To this I say no, although there is a very, very small chance that a center cone-forming eruption could occur. However, such an eruption, if it were to occur, will be one or two orders of magnitude less explosive than what La Palma produced in 2021. What is the expected VEI of a potential eruption? To this, I say a VEI 0 is the most likely, although there's a little less than a 50% chance a VEI 1 or VEI 2 eruption occurs. Please stay safe, everyone, and stay away from the current closures, aka Grindavik, in any area around or above the 15-kilometer long dike. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Boston Heath, for supporting this channel.